The best way to become familiar with objects is to use lots of them. Here we will look at strings, and we will do it in three ways: with BlueJ objects, with Java code, and with another nifty tool called the CodePad. In the CodePad, as you'll see in a minute, I can type in code and have it executed right away without having to compile anything or without having to click on the bubbles. The CodePad is so nifty that it's a shame that it's hidden. To reveal it, select View and Show CodePad. And then they make it so small, which is also a shame. Let's make it much, much bigger. In the CodePad, I can write regular Java statements. Here I declare a variable. Here I have a print statement. And as soon as I hit the Enter key, it gets executed. You see a window pops up that has the output. But what's even better, any value that I type in here gets displayed right away. Let me show you. I type river.length, and the answer 11 is displayed as soon as I hit the Enter key. It's important that you don't type a semicolon, because otherwise the CodePad thinks that you have a statement, like up here. No semicolon tells it that it should immediately print the value of the code that you write. Here I type the name of the variable without a semicolon, and it's printed, the string Mississippi. And to the left, I have a little blob that I can drag into the workbench. Here it goes. I drop it in the workbench. Now I'm supposed to give it a name. I'll give it the same name that the variable has, river. And over here, I have a familiar BlueJ blob that I can manipulate in the usual way. I can right-click on it. And now the string class has many, many methods, but I want to call length. When I selected the length method, I get the answer 11. So I can get the same answer in two different ways. Which one is better? It really depends. Sometimes I prefer to use the BlueJ bubbles for quick experimentation, because you can't really make any typos. Sometimes I prefer to use the CodePad, because it's just easier to type in, maybe to copy and paste in what you want. Both of those are great for experimenting with classes and objects and to just find out what happens when you call a particular method. You should try them both and see which one you like better. Of course, for more hardcore programming, for writing a program that gets repeated over and over again, one wants to write an actual Java class with a main method. In that case, as you know, you right-click on the empty space, make a new class. Right-click, open the editor, and start typing. Then you put your code into the main method. Here I wrote a couple of lines of code that let me compute the length of the string. You compile, you run, and you get the answer. That's more work at first, and it'll pay off when you write a longer program. For short explorations, the object bubbles and the code pad are hard to beat. So go ahead, fire up BlueJ, and work along with Sarah to explore the string class and its methods.